So we are in a town on the border of Arizona and Nevada called Laughlin, about an hour and a half south of Las Vegas. So we're here putting the latest prototype trucks through their paces. This is one of the most grueling roads in the country. It's a steep uphill climb, and it's about 110 degrees out here this week. So we're basically stretching the truck to its limits to see what it can do.
So we brought four trucks on our trip, and each one of them has a different payload capacity to evaluate the different driving conditions that real-world customers will experience. The reason we took multiple different loads is we want to try to emulate as best as we can today how these trucks are going to be used by the customer. So we have one trailer that's around 41,000 gross vehicle weight, and that's really, you know, targeted at somebody who's transporting a large voluminous thing, but maybe it's not very heavy. Something like tissue paper or toilet paper takes up a lot of space but doesn't have a lot of weight. Then we have another vehicle that's slated at 59K GVW, and that is kind of the mid-load, right? So a truck that's hauling a mid-weight item. We have two trucks that are doing 82,000 pound gross vehicle weight, and the real goal of those trucks is to max out the capability. So we want to push the trucks to their boundary limit conditions in these hot environmental conditions. We have a driver in each truck and an engineer in each truck, and each truck is really focused on a different functional subsystem and evaluation of that subsystem. So we're looking at things like thermal performance, the capability to drive in all electric, the blended hybrid modes, ensuring that components are functional in the variety of test cases and temperature regions. So our days start off early in the morning. We do a kickoff, so we kind of align with the team. These are the goals for the day. We spend a little bit of time looking through some data and doing some analysis. As the morning gets to mid-morning or late morning, that's when the temperatures start to rise, so we get in the trucks. Typically, we'll be updating software and calibrations, kind of getting ready for the day, and then we kick off each truck into their own kind of test profile.
You don't think about it much driving a passenger vehicle because you're not towing, you know, 40, 50,000 pounds. But a grade is just an inclined road. So it's a big deal for a Class 8 truck. When you're towing like a full load, like 60,000 pounds or so in your trailer, any percentage of incline really affects the performance. You need a lot more power to get up because you're towing such heavy weight. So some of these passes, these mountain passes, are very steep, and this one in particular, when you combine with the heat, it just stretches the truck to its limit. It's basically using all of its horsepower, all of its power, to try to get up the hill and get that weight over the hill. So, you know, this is one of the steepest ones in the country. Combined with the heat, there's really no better place to check out what the truck can do. So we're looking to leave this test and this week with confidence. From my side, sending it up this very grueling, like, peak performance road will tell us a lot about how the vehicle was designed, the parts we picked, how it was put together, to kind of confirm that all that engineering work that was performed was performed right, and it's coming to fruition in a truck that is going to be successful, right? So we have high confidence about that already, but this is more of a confirmation of that.
So what's next for the team and the trucks? Once we get back to Austin, we're going to do a deep dive of all the issues, all the data, everything that we found. We're going to make sure that we can drive all of those items to closure. And that really just makes sure that we have a reliable product, a high quality functional product. From there, we're going to ramp into some of our OBD and diagnostic development work. So that's kind of the next big chapter that the team is going to be tackling. And then we're in the full prep for controlled fleet trials. So as we get there, we will start getting the trucks ramped up into customer hands and start taking some feedback from there.